and welcome to News Tonight with me, Deepthi. Before we move to all the stories for today in detail, let's have a quick look at the top headlines. India takes a tough call on the issue of the Tamil Nadu fisherman killed by US Navy ship, asks UAE to register a case. Chief Minister Jayalalitha condoles the killing of fishermen and announces a solatium of 5 lakh to his family. A special court rejects Jayalalitha's plea to defer DA case petitions to Karnataka High Court. Mamata Banerjee does a U-turn over the presidential poll as she announces that she will go with Pranab Mukherjee. And across the border, a Pakistani court deems the 2611 panel's report illegal. Team India gets a new training jersey ahead of its tour to Sri Lanka. The Soyuz spacecraft carrying Sunita Williams and two engineers lands at the International Space Station to a rousing welcome. News in detail. India has sought a report from its ambassador in the UAE on the killing of an Indian fisherman in a US Navy ship firing at a docking point in Dubai, even as the US authorities said that the incident is under investigation. External Affairs Minister S.M. Krishna has sought a report on the incident from the Indian ambassador to Dubai, M.K. Lokesh, apart from asking the government there to investigate the case. An Indian fisherman was killed and three others were wounded yesterday when a security team on board a US Navy ship fired at their small boat off Dubai. The dead fisherman has been identified as Shekhar of Periyapattinam in Ramanathapuram district.
Well, we are in touch with our ambassadors in United States, in Dubai. We have instructed them to take it up with the respective governments. I learned from our ambassador in Dubai that the government of Dubai have filed a case against this incident and they are proceeding according to the laws of that country.
Dubai incident involving a US naval ship and a boat that had Indian fishermen is indeed very tragic. But if we look at the sequence of events, my own inference at this stage is that the rules of engagement, that is the rules under which a warship, whether it is the United States or any other country, response as far as use of ordnance is concerned, needs to be spelt out far more clearly. Now, pending the investigation, at which point we will have more details, it does appear that after the USS Cole incident, the US Navy has become very, very apprehensive. Prima facie, based on the reports in the media, it appears that this particular smaller boat with the Indian fishermen was trying to approach the US warship, and they may or may not have understood the communication that was being conveyed to them, which led, I think, to the opening of fire by the personnel on the US naval ship.
This is not the first time Indian fishermen are being shot, earlier by Italians. And near Kachathivu, we had several times incidents of Sri Lankan Navy attacking Indian fishermen. In this particular incident, no warning was being given at all, and the fishermen have been attacked. We demand a probe, a comprehensive probe as to how this incident happened. Was there a warning issued? Was there a communication gap? All this will have to be established. And we demand the US authorities to understand that even though it was done in high seas, fishermen who were there eking out their own livelihood have been killed. We demand an apology from them, and the UAE authorities should immediately file cases on this matter.
देखिए भारत की सरकार को इस पर गंभीरता से और कड़े कड़ाई के साथ रुख अपनाना चाहिए. जो इंडियन फिशरमैन को अमेरिकी फौजों ने पकड़ा है या किसी और ने पकड़ा है और गलत तरीके से पकड़ा है, उनको छुड़ाने के लिए तत्काल कूटनीतिक प्रयास और कोशिशें की जाए. हाँ, और पकड़ा भी है और उसके साथ हिंसा भी हुई है अगर, तो ये अपने आप में और खतरनाक बात है और इसमें सरकार को सीधे हस्तक्षेप करना चाहिए।
The three injured in the incident are Muniraj, Panbhuvan and Murugan, who are also from Ramanathapuram. One of them has been admitted to hospital with bullet injuries. The Fishermen's Association president said that all of them were working for Dubai fishing companies on a daily wage basis. The families in India are meanwhile devastated.
வெளிநாடு போய் 10 மாசம் துபாய் போனான். துபாய் போயிட்டு மீன் பிடிக்க காலையில் போனாங்கண்ணா. போனப்போ அமெரிக்கா கடற்படை வந்து ஷூட்டிங் பண்ணிட்டாங்கண்ணா. ஷூட்டிங் பண்ணி ரெண்டு மூணு பேர்
ஒரு ஆள் இறந்து
போயிட்டா, ரெண்டு பேர் கடலில் விட்டாங்களாம். மூணு பேருக்கு காயங்களாம். என் மையம் பேர் முத்துமணியராஜ், ஆர் முத்துமணியராஜ். ரெண்டு கால்லையும் அடிபட்டிருக்கான், காலுக்கு ஆபத்தாக இருக்கான். தமிழக அரசு தகுந்த நடவடிக்கை எடுத்து என் பிள்ளையில எல்லாரையுமே தமிழ்நாட்டுக்கு கொண்டு வந்து நல்ல சிகிச்சை எடுத்து நல்லபடியாக கால் இருக்கிற மாதிரியே என் பிள்ளைகளுக்கு செய்யணும். என் பிள்ளைக்கு
என் கணவர் பேர் ஆர் முத்துமணியராஜ். அவங்க கல்யாணம் முடிஞ்சு ஒரு மாதத்துலேயே வெளிநாடு போனாங்க,
துபாய்
போனாங்க. அப்போ திடீர்னு இன்னைக்கு ஃபோன் வந்துச்சு, அமெரிக்காக்காரை வந்து இப்படி சூட் பண்ணிட்டாங்களாம் காலில். அதனாண்டி எப்படியாவது மத்திய மாநில அரசு
Meanwhile, Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Jay Jayalalitha asked Manmohan Singh to take up with the US and UAE the shooting of the death of a Tamil Nadu fisherman by personnel on board a US ship in Dubai Seas and seek a detailed probe. Letter to Mr. Singh, she said that, "I request you to kindly take up this matter with the governments of United States and Dubai to cause a detailed inquiry into the incident. I also request you to ensure that due compensation is paid the families of the deceased and injured fishermen, as the dead and injured fishermen are innocent fishermen who are fishing in the sea only for their livelihood. Please ensure that justice is rendered." The Chief Minister also announced a relief of 5 lakh to the kin of the deceased seeker and 50,000 each to 3 injured. Moving on, after several weeks of drama, Trinamool Congress Supremo and West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee today announced that her party will vote for UPA nominee Pranab Mukherjee in presidential election. Ms. Banerjee was also not on board with Ansari as Vice President. The UPA meet on Saturday to finalize the name for Vice President was attended by Mukul Roy on behalf of Trinamool Congress. It's very unlikely that Ms. Banerjee will support Mr. Ansari, given that he was endorsed for the post 5 years ago by her arch rival, the Left.
Yeah, he's very happy because today also he told me that, "Mamata ji, may I tell you to support?" So Nuri ji rakhu hai bolen arki. I will be happy to know that our party decided to support him. Vice President will decide later on. There is a time. Time is there. So we are not contesting. Even Krishna Basu should have been a good choice. So, but for the greater interest, we are not contesting.
उन्होंने जो बयान दिया है वो भी आज बहुत अच्छा बयान दिया है. वोट की इज्जत के लिए मैंने ये फैसला किया है. राष्ट्रपति का चुनाव बड़ा चुनाव है और बोर्ड जो है वो मेरा बोर्ड जो है वो डालने का फर्ज है, इसलिए मैं अपनी पार्टी की तरफ से वोट डाल रही हूँ. तो वो तो लड़ाकू महिला है, संघर्ष की महिला है.
आई एम एब्सोल्युटली पर्सनली डिलाइटेड बिकॉज आई हैड वेंचर्ड टू से अ कपल ऑफ टाइम्स टू द मीडिया that I was very hopeful that she would stand by the UPA choice, that she is a person who has the right feelings. She has some concerns about many political positions that she believes are necessary for the best possible outlook of her own state. But I think that her heart is in the right place.
Congress President Sonia Gandhi held brief interactions with party MPs from all states on the issue of the presidential election, for which voting will take place on Thursday. Emerging from the meeting, Union Minister Harish Rawat told reporters that such meetings are held ahead of every presidential and vice presidential election. Also, he dismissed the possibility of cross-voting in the UPA camp when pointed out that the NDA-backed opposition nominee P.S. Sangma is pinning hope on a conscience vote in the presidential poll.
और ये एक प्रकार की नॉर्मल मीटिंग है और हमेशा जो है इस तरीके की मीटिंग जो है ऐसे बड़े चुनावों से पहले आयोजित होती रही है और इस बार भी आयोजित की गई है और कल भी ये प्रोसेस रहेगी और कल लंच के बाद जो है कुछ राज्यों के सांसदगण माननीय कांग्रेस अध्यक्षा से मिलेंगे। नहीं, बिल्कुल नहीं, कहीं कोई क्रॉस वोटिंग का खतरा नहीं है और यदि ये खतरा है तो वो एनडीए के कैंप में है जहां और भाजपा के कैंप में है जहां के कुछ सांसद पहले ही जो है प्रणब मुखर्जी साहब के लिए अपनी ओपिनियन साफ साफ जाहिर कर चुके हैं और उनका जो हर कोई भी जो कार्ड उनका था वो कार्ड जो है बिल्कुल भौतरा साबित हो चुका है। इसलिए कहीं पर कांग्रेस के अंदर या यूपीए के अंदर इस बात को लेकर के चिंता नहीं है, हम बिल्कुल आश्वस्त हैं।
MPs and MLAs representing DMK attended a meeting in Chennai today, the agenda of which was to discuss modalities of voting in the upcoming presidential poll. DMK meanwhile has already extended support to Pranab Mukherjee.
அந்த முடிவை நல்ல முறையில் நிறைவேற்ற வேண்டும் என்பதற்கு வழிமுறையில்
ஃபார்மல் இன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ஷன்ஸ் வர் கிவன் இன் தி என்சுயிங் பிரசிடென்ட் எலெக்ஷன்ஸ் மெம்பர்ஸ் ஆஃப் பார்லிமெண்ட் யூஸ் டு ஓட் இன் டெல்லி அண்ட் லெஜிஸ்லேட்டிவ் அசம்பிளி மெம்பர்ஸ் வில் ஓட் இன் சென்னை. And any member of parliament who has sought a special permission to vote in Chennai, they were asked to get it confirmed and exercise their franchise here to cast their vote in Chennai. All other MPs have to be in Delhi and the MLAs should vote here.
More news and updates on the other side of a very short break. Stay with us.